Hey, good morning, everyone. So you can hear me, right? Okay. Today we are going to start the session about the ETAP. The topic today will be the nonlinear state construction analysis. Okay. I'm going to start now. Okay. So what is the okay. What is the nonlinear state construction analysis, right? So normally when for the normal analysis, if you have a start from nothing, right, we have only grid line. When you click analyze, program you will analyze one time like this. Okay. One step, you complete the four-story building. But normally, yeah, construction at site will be go one by one, right? From nothing and story one, story two, three, and four until complete. So now the your normal analysis now is different from the construction at site. Okay. So to simulate the.
Ibig sabihin sa 15 hindi pa tayo makakaon.
Hello. Please turn off your mic first. If you want to have a question, you can send me a message, right? Okay. So to simulate the real construction step at site, you can do in ETAP. We call the auto construction sequence load case. And this feature you available in define when you go to define the top menu, right? And go to auto construction sequence case. Will appear dialog like this. Okay. So from this you can specify the parameter. I'm going to explain you in next slide. Okay. First option is the geometric nonlinearity option. Right? So this option they have a three. You can select three. So one is non is not considered, right? Next is the P delta. And the last one will be P delta plus last displacement. Okay. For the first option for the P delta, right? This is like this. If you have a, suppose you have the column and you have the gravity load P and you have the lateral load, lateral force F. Okay. When the column is defect delta, in this one, the column will have the additional moment P multiplied by the delta. This one we call the P delta of effect. If you select this option, program will consider this additional moment into your structure. Okay. And for P delta with the last displacement, this one is for the cable structure. Normally for the auto construction sequence load, we consider only the load during construction and when or lateral force will not consider. Okay. Okay. So next option will be the number of story in group, right? So you can specify not only one, you can specify more than one to your step in each step. Suppose I have four story building and I specify this to be two story at each construction sequence group. That means if you have so this from four story, they will divide into two step. Okay, the first step will add story one and story two, and next step will be story three and story four like this. So if you specify only one story in the sequence, so they will start story by story. So the construction sequence will have a four step like this. So if you specify less number of story, more step will be required and more time to analyze. Okay, so if you have like a 30 story, if you add only one story, it's more. It will have a 30 step. So you can balance this one. Okay, and next option will be the exclude this group until the last step. Okay, this one you can group some structure and define in this select on this group and this structure will be at the end. Suppose I have 10 story building and this is nine story already. And last step, I will add the bridge link to this one. I assign as a group one. So I select group one. This group, the structure in group one will be added at the last step. Okay, this is like this. And load apply, the next one is load apply, okay? So this one normally we consider the load during the construction. Normally will be dead load and superimpose dead load. You can specify in any load case from here, okay? And the last thing is about a view analysis result. This construction sequence will be different from a normal analysis. Every result from deform shape, member force, or reaction. So from this, you're going to have more option. So you can view the step. Like if you have four story and you specify the one story per step, you have four step. You can view the step by step of your force, what happened in your structure. Or you can select absolute max, or you can select to show max only or min only. Can see on this one also. Okay. So next, I'm going to explain you about what is different from the normal analysis and construction sequence analysis. Right? So for the symmetrical stiffness building, right? So we check the vertical deflection at the top and compare with construction sequence analysis. You can see that the construction sequence analysis, the vertical deflection at the top will be less than the normal analysis. Why it's happened like this? I explain you in next slide. Okay. So for the construction sequence analysis, when you add the step one, okay, and this one is the start of step two, right? Program will start the level two at the story tool, right? At start the structure. So this one they adjust the length. So it's different from the normal acid. Normal acid will accumulate whatever length is here. They will not adjust this one. But normally in the construction, they will check the floor leveling and adjust the story into the level accurate level. That's why you got the vertical deflection from the construction sequence less than the normal analysis. Okay. How about the unsymmetrical stiffness building? Okay, like this. So you have one side is the shear wall, and one side, another side is column. So one side the stiffness is more than the other side. Okay. So from this, if you compare the normal analysis with the construction sequence, check at the top. Okay. So from the vertical displacement is same as the symmetrical stiffness. It's also normalized more than the construction sequence analysis for the deflection. But not only the vertical deflection, and also lateral also, you can see this one. Lateral from normalized is about 8 millimeter, while construction sequence analysis is only 1 millimeter. It's about 8 times more than the correlation sequence analysis. Why it's happened like this? Because it's same answer as the vertical. So same answer as the symmetrical stiffness building. Okay. When you're going to add the step two program, we adjust the floor. Okay. To be at the floor level at the story two, like this, so adjust the length. And not adjust the length, and also the horizontal also step back, not continue from the story one. That's why you got the vertical deflection and also lateral deflection from the construction sequence less than normal analysis. Okay. And next one is the okay. Why? Because This one for symmetrical stiffness, no lateral deformation, right? Why the unsymmetrical stiffness, you have the lateral deformation because you can see in the right side, there's a shear wall, right? Shear wall is more stiffener, so that means the less deformation than the column here. Okay? In the left side, the column is less stiffness and more vertical deformation. So that means vertical deformation at the left is settled more than the right. That means that make the building is stiff on the left. That's why you have the lateral deformation. And this will be reduced if you use the correction sequence analysis. And this one happened in our project, the real project. We have the 30-story building, right? First, when we analyze with the normal analysis, we got the lateral deformation from the gravity load is more than the lateral load from the wind. So we search and found this one. So after we use the correction sequence analysis, the lateral deformation is reduced a lot. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And next one, if you have some special structure, like you have a truss, like this one is like this transfer column will support by the truss system of the whole story on the three story. Okay. From this, if you use correction sequence, correction sequence will be more than the normal analysis. Why? Because of the during construction, right? If you use like this program, you start story by story. If in the step two, the task is not complete, right? So that means your deflection will be more, okay? And another reason, in the real construction, normally we need to have a temporary support, okay? Until the complete task is constructed. After that, they will remove this temporary support later. So to do this, you cannot use the auto construction sequence analysis. So, but program from the ETAP, they allow you to do the manual construction sequence analysis also. So to do that, you can go to, we call nonlinear state construction. Right? From this, you go to define load case. Okay. And after that, you select load case type to be the nonlinear state construction. Okay, from this, so from this you can adjust, add or remove define your state operation by yourself. Okay, from this you can add this one. We call add step and also define, we call the state operation. Okay, from state operation, you can have many options like add structure, remove structure. Remove structure, the one that I mentioned. Eh? So you can remove structure. You can define this last step and remove structure. Okay. From that, you group the temporary support and remove. And load object, if added, load object, change section, and also change section and edge. For edge, so you can define the non-linear material, concrete, crib, and shingle. And you can specify the day of the concrete, okay? So you can do that also in the nonlinear state construction. Oh. Okay, so for add or remove structure, you can select the object type by add by group, story, joint frame, and shell also. From joint frame and shell, you can select the ID, structure ID from the list, okay? And after you define, you can check the tree on each step, like this. Okay, so I go to show you the real program about this also. Let me change the screen. One. Okay. Okay. So from this you can go to define and add auto construction sequence load. Okay. After add, after you click OK from this, then you go to define and load cases. You can see that auto sequence is already add. Okay. And I suggest you to add auto construction sequence first, and you can click add copy of case. Right? When you select this, there are another one that copy from the auto construction sequence. This one you can modify. For the auto construction sequence, you cannot modify anything. Okay. So from this, you can modify. And I suggest you to study from this how program modify. And when you know, you can specify the state operation by your own. Okay. From this, you can select any step. So from my structure, I have 10 story, right? And I add one story at the each step. So that's why I have a state number, have 10 state number. Okay. And if I select this one, so number two, and you can select state operation. Okay. This will show this one. So from this, the add structure and select add by story and use the story two. Okay. After that, the second one, not only structure, you need to add load also. So this one we have add load. Add option, load object if added, and you can select the group and all, and load pattern is select by date, so you can specify your own or complex the step, okay, from this. And also you can review the tree, this one. So this one is explain about each step. Can check each step of this. Of the this one is about the 10 story and one story per step, right? We can check from this also. Okay, so this is about the construction sequence. Okay, so anyone has a question? Okay, so if there's no any question, I will end this session, or you can send me the question or also some recommend about the topic. And for, okay. Okay, thank you for watching.